Welcome back, everybody. I'm Kiralis, and this is the next episode of City Skylines. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy. What a view, right? Holy crap, alright, I did this off camera. This is something which has been super requested by you guys that I should place. Like, I showed you guys this like ages ago, and since then you guys have been like, place it. So I did, and yeah, it was not really that easy to place, to be honest, but I think it looks breathtaking. Holy crap. Like, especially like night scenarios with the lights. This is the Brooklyn Bridge, by the way. It's kind of misplaced, I guess. But you know what? It's not that bad. Hopefully you guys can see. I think you can even see better at night scenarios. You know that we had this highway here, which kind of ended in the Brooklyn suburb over here? Now it goes all the way here, across the Brooklyn Bridge. Oh, Popo. Zoom in on the Popo. Stop. Oh yeah, he's in a hurry. So it goes all the way here, across the bridge, and it goes in to the airport highway. don't judge this, alright? I couldn't get this straight. I was trying so many different scenarios, and it just doesn't snap correctly. So, for the moment being, in case people kind of want to get back to the airport, they can just use this like lollip and then go back into the airport. But it's used. It's actually being used by people. Oh no, let me just go into today's scenario. Like this, get some sun into this bad boy. And there we go. I need to sneeze. And we are back. I'm sorry about that. Holy crap, I still got the grass allergies, which sucks so bad. It's like the worst thing ever. I tried like every single medicine, and I even have like injections, and it doesn't help. But anyhow, so now this is used, and I just think like it's super bendy, and it's super perfect. What comes for the Brooklyn Bridge, Shroomblaze made a just a fantastic job. Like, look at those like passages here which you can place road using mods and stuff. I kind of did a little attempt here. I haven't really done anything else, like I haven't connected it up yet, but it's amazing. And lining this up was not easy. So let me just show you how kinda is done, just so you guys can kind of envision the pain and agony it's caused me. You go into this category, and I think it's somewhere hidden in this. Yes, it is. So you need to have the sub building enabled, the mod. Everything is in the Shroomblaze description on the workshop. So you place the bridge first of all, right? And I'm just gonna put it down here like this. There we got the bridge. It looks pretty fabulous. Everything is set up with the lights and whatnot. And then you grab the like the ends, and now it might line up because I have terraformed. No, it doesn't. See. So you need to terraform the part of the land which is going to be situated in into the correct level. And I kind of grabbed a level which is a little bit higher than my sea levels or river levels. I think I might have tweaked them myself. So if you would grab one which is just on the water level, it would have worked. It didn't for me, so I had to kind of rise down the land here. So it kind of looks a bit dirt, but we can hide that away with buildings later on. So everybody, don't worry about that. Let's just remove this. And in my opinion, it's fantastic. You even got this little passage up here. This is a bike path, I think. Oh no, I spotted a mistake. It's a big mistake. We're gonna fix it though. Today's episode, by the way, is gonna be mostly like a tour episode. We're just gonna tour about as promised. There we go. It's not like super perfect, but it's almost, and I'm happy with it. All right, did I do this on this side? Like spike, yes, this side is correct, I think. Connected and fine. Yeah, look at this little bike passage up here, and this is kind of like a little boardwalk thingy with the bike lanes. It's just incredible, like fantastic bridge. I'm loving it, but yes. Today's episode is going to be a tour episode, as promised, episode 50, because there's been a lot of people kind of jumping in and out of the series, and you might have missed out and you don't want to watch or rewatch all the episodes. So we're going to take a little tour. We kind of started out building like a European town type of situation. Actually, I think this was smaller versions of houses, like just low residential zones in the beginning, and then we're going to tweak that. But this is, for me, this area is like a little hate relationship. I don't like it anymore. Like, I hate it. Like, every time I go visit here, I get sad. Oh my god, I still have it. You know what? No. Let's fix this in this episode. I mean, this is called a funeral procession, right? So if I go into this guy and search for funeral, can I even search in this? Yes, not Finn again, funeral. That's the trailer car, right? So basically, the car behind has 100 kilometers and this has got 15. So what if we double that to 40 maximum? Save, and let's now see. Will you speed up, dude? It's gonna be super speedy now. I'm loving it. All right, so that works. I think it looks still pretty amazing. So I still want to keep that because I think it's a kind of a cool addition and feature. And now it works using the vehicle, the advanced vehicle options. So yeah, this area here is gonna be absolutely tweaked and remodeled. I don't like it anymore. Like, I know people kind of get attached to stuff, if you know what I mean. Like, some of you might be like, you get this little like part of the city, which you really, I just hate how they are kind of purple on distance or pink. Nothing against pink cars, but holy crap, this looks bad. Some people get really like attached to parts of the city, and then I kind of like, nope, let's demolish, rebuild, and they're like, unsub, you suck. But I need to be happy with stuff. I really need to be happy with stuff, and I'm not really happy with this part whatsoever. Like, I mean, it's not bad looking or whatnot. The main problem I have, I'm gonna grab custom assets, which goes for buildings. Because I hate, like, in a real-life scenario, this is not bad. There's commercials on buildings, right, in big cities. Nothing wrong with that. But this is kind of like a Christmas tree of commercials on all the, like, in-game buildings. I think that is so bad-looking. And it's just kind of like, oh my god, the sounds from this. And it's just kind of, like, I mean, night scenario. Let me just see here. How does this look at night, by the way? Let's go to, like, evening at least. Bam. Night scenarios, this might be like, whoa, it's amazing and it's beautiful and it's lit up like a Christmas tree. But at the end of the day, I hate it. I absolutely hate it. so terrible with this. And we have where ambulances and everything is kind of like messed up. So this is kind of like the first area we started off. And yes, it is going to be retweaked. It's going to be demolished. It's going to be rebuilt with custom assets. And I think we're kind of going to fix it. I don't think the canals are even going to stay. I think we might remove them. I mean, they look beautiful. Like before we had like those in-game official canals, this was the only way to go about, I guess, to make it some type of canal cozy feel. And then they added the in-games one, which I don't really like either, to be honest. So we might just go without them, or we just might kind of like reduce them or something. Because they don't really make any sense whatsoever now. Then we kind of moved on. We've built this like, I started building something using, oh no. Oh, I thought it was like a train queue, but it's only like a few trains. Yeah, we're going to tweak that. I started using this type of situation where we had the rails kind of like on an elevation with trees on both sides. And something I hate as well. I don't like that anymore whatsoever, but for the moment being, I have to just live with that. Like, I love the elevated train tracks. I just don't like how it looks here, for example. Like, I mean, I haven't really detailed this area whatsoever, so it's kind of like really hard to like, yeah, it's kind of like, yeah. It's bad. Like, I mean, look at that. Trains are stopping. We get like pushes in the rails and everything. It's kind of like meh. Then we actually moved on to something really cool, which has changed a bit. Look at the level of detail on those. Or something is messed up with those buildings. This wasn't like this before. Like, the garages were perfectly fine. Now they're kind of like glitching out on zoom in and zoom out. But we did make like start out with British suburbs, and I still love this part, right? Those, by the way, which we get here, like those train tracks with those like beautiful trees, I still like them. Nothing I want to change. I kind of want to keep those guys. I love the British suburbs, even though it's not really finished. Like, you see, there's gaps here and there, and there's buildings missing because something is, I guess, burned down and they haven't replaced it, or the tiles have changed, as you can see here, so we can't really squeeze in anything. So stuff like this, I need to get back to remodel, refix. But overall, the atmosphere down here is pretty brilliant. The FPS pretty much sucks. but it is a beautiful part of the city. And this is something, when I started out the series, I didn't have like unlimited money. I had to kind of like grind every single buck. So I guess some of the parts here are kind of like a little bit uncreative, if you know what I mean. Like, they just lack the level of detail. Oh, no, it's bad. Don't worry, we got an American fire engine on the destination, and it's out. So I think we might keep like a lot of it, but we're also gonna tweak and put tons of details. Like, for example, those shops here. Love, hate, I don't know. Like, they're not bad looking, and they're pretty British, like high street. No, maybe not high street, but you know what I mean. Like, it's just British, and they kind of fit the theme, but I think I need to grab more of them or something, because they're kind of like so repetitive, like the same building, same building, same building, same building. But nevertheless, the city is pretty baller looking anyhow. So yeah, so we kind of started off, we did like this first British suburb, which was here. Then we kind of moved here. And I think the next step was this step over here, right? We kind of squeezed them, and this looks exactly the same. The only main difference here is the road layout. And this is something I'm really proud of, by the way, because I think it looks pretty nice. Even night scenarios in this bad boy are pretty amazeballs. Like, it's so, like, the lights, for example. Everything here is so different and so laggy, but It's not really a grid pattern. Like, some buildings go this way, some buildings go that way, some buildings turn, some buildings just are like all over the place. And I love it. I love it a lot. If my voice is still dirt, by the way, it's just because I still got my fever. I think I've said that already, because I sneezed before and it's bad. I love it. So yeah, we built that, and I'm really proud of the road systems. There are so much which kind of lack here. Like, for example, like public transportation. We haven't really connected much into this area, and we haven't really thought about it. I like this little thing, which is really not... Like, this was before I went to, like, detail mayhem. And see? I spotted something. This bush. This tree. How the hell? Why? Don't worry. It is gone now, but wasn't looking that good now, was it? Like, for example, this. And you know what I think this is? This is when some of the mods broke. Like, the prop anarchy was broken off. Or broken. So every single tree kind of regrew on the streets and stuff, and some stuff are kind of still derped up. We also made a little, like, commercial zone, which kind of was... This was a little bit more detailed, I think. Like, we added a little bit more detail. We added, like, little parks. We had, like, billboards and whatnot. We added, like, tons of bushes and beautiful shop. Like, for example, Asda in the 2FPS version here. We have Tesco's across the street. That is kind of, like, super British, I think, right? Open 24 hours and everything is amazing. The hippie wagon is just outside. It's beautiful. Carphone warehouse. Never been to one, but I guess they sell mobile phones or something. Toys R Us, pets at home, and those little public restrooms. But that, like, I don't know, I just like the ambiance in the British suburbs, so I'm not going to tweak them too much, but I'm going to kind of remodel them anyhow. Also got boots, that is super British. Yeah, like, I mean, it's not bad, but it's not really perfect, no, I don't know, is it? Then I think we kind of moved away a little bit. We went into the golf course. We made a Swedish suburbs, which are pretty amazing. Like, it's a lot of, like, if you just look from above, it looks kind of boring. And that is mainly, like, a lot of people have been commenting on this, by the way. It's mainly because nothing is connected to it. Like, if we would have expanded the zone just to this highway, for example, right? It would have looked totally different. And for example, here, and then just kind of fill this area in. Because then it would look kind of connected. Now it's just kind of like a grid pattern. It's a perfect square or rectangle, and just, yeah. But it's going to be tweaked. It's going to be fixed. It's going to be modeled, and it's going to be remodeled, and it's going to be just amazing. If the game allows us that is, if it doesn't crash and everything. The golf course itself, this is pretty detailed. This was like one of the most detailed things I've done in the beginning stages of the game. The buffalo grill has been here forever. It's a tree growing through it. See, this is from the mod. All right, let me remove that, and the tree is gone. And okay, we got some grass problems as well. Don't worry. Stuff like this is pretty amazing. Doing tours from now and then and just fixing stuff, I think that's just spot on. And also, like, before I started recording this episode, I tried to do some first-person rides in cars and stuff like that. And it was just bad because it lagged so much. We're gonna go down to first-person level and just go touring about the city in a later stage in this video, but this area is really bad for it because it has so much lag, especially like the British parts. I don't know, maybe that is just kind of like the models are really like demanding or something, or just big in the textures and stuff or whatnot. I like the Swedish houses. I think they're just amazing. Like, I live in Sweden, so I see kind of similar stuff on a daily basis, so maybe not those though, but I see stuff like this and it kind of feels just at home a little bit. We have some bus routes here, we have popos, we have a lot of popos. Damn, it's just beautiful. It's definitely cozy. There are a police station in the middle of everything. I don't know, there's something about this game. Especially like in first person, when you just get down on street level, you can have like the depth of field and everything is just zoomed in and just looks amazing. It just, I don't know, just triggers my nerd senses. I love it. What is that guy doing on a skateboard in the swing department? This is a beautiful like playground park. Nobody's actually like using their things, but it looks pretty epic. That guy, holy crap. I love the Swedish parts. I know there's very mixed comments about this area, but we're gonna get to that. Like, for example, like the golf clubhouse. This is it. I haven't even got to that and fix it. Like, I mean, it's not that hard. It's just picking a road, going back in here, some car parks and stuff, and it's done. I just haven't got around to do that yet, but it's gonna come, so don't worry about it. Swedes love recycling, so we added some recycling centers here. We have this beautiful Buffalo Grill, once again, with some Burning People facilities just across the street. Just to kind of spice up the flavors in the Buffalo Grill, I guess, I don't know. The barbecue. The barbecue, holy crap. And then I kind of tweaked this a little bit, because this tree here, got out of the Steam Workshop, so I kind of replaced some of the streets. I moved this back, I think. Yes, I did, because we added that new highway extension here, and it kind of, just to kind of line up with that road going all the way to the city, we had to move that back. And it looks beautiful, especially those trees in the Swedish suburb. I mean, they are epic. And I think there's even like, I think you call it conifers, which are kind of the same design. They're not like, not really that design, but they're very, 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 very close to that. So we're gonna change that about as well. And a few episodes before that, I think we went into the industrial area over here, which has been tweaked when it comes to the road access and stuff, but we did put this here, and to be fair, not sure we're gonna keep it here for a long time. For the moment being, it can stay. But especially like when the city grows and it kind of reaches the borders here, it might not look good. I mean, I ain't moving the poop lagoon. This is such a lifesaver. This is something we did in an episode as well. It's a big poop lagoon. And for anybody playing this game, this is something I would totally recommend. It might have been one of those guys. I can't really remember if it was or not. But I don't think it was, because then that doesn't make any sense. That is the... I'm gonna just put down that for the moment being. That is a big problem. When you're doing stuff and grab assets and mods from the Steam Workshop, like, I mean, one day the person who made it can just decide, like, nah, not happy with it anymore, I'm just gonna remove it, and it kind of vanishes in your city. And since my city is kind of like 90% assets and custom buildings, that's a pain. I kind of found that out when the big downtown was kind of like, well, it was in ruins. Somebody removed all the New York buildings, and I had just empty gaps in the whole thing. But we did also, very overexposed from that angle, we did also build like what, like I grabbed those like silos and tanks, or what you gonna call them. And we started building something here, which has been here forever. Not much detail, not much decoration, but I still kind of like it. I don't know, it's just kind of cool design. And this industry area, well, for the moment being, it's working, so there's no idea, like, no reason to change it. But look how bad this looks, for example. Like, I haven't even finished this off. So there's places in the city which definitely needs a lot of tweaking and a lot of, kind of, like, time to kind of change. And I'm just going to be flying about the different parts. We're going to see how this kind of turns out. But one area which I'm really proud of is the harbor. I mean, this harbor is my little baby. I've spent so many hours on this, and it's not even done. Like, I mean, I guess it's like halfway done. I mean, we're missing stuff in the harbor, but it is definitely my little baby over here. There's so much detail and decoration going into this place. Is this scene of accident still in? Yeah, look at that. The guy who's got his head crash is still around. Tons of containers, and what I think has happened in somewhere on the route here is that some of the train connection is broken, so no trains can reach that area. And I think it might be somewhere here, because like, look at this guy, which goes into the Russian suburbs, he has no problem getting in and out. So I think somewhere along this road something, or I mean the train line is broken. Because we have trains from this area, we have trains from that area, we have trains from this area, and it's not working. So I think it's gonna be somewhere here on the routes. And I think it might be here. I'm wondering if we connect that guy, if it's gonna start working. So I think, yeah, somewhere here is broken, and we need to kind of fix that, and we need to kind of find the area which is kind of broken. But we're gonna get to that, alright? The harbor is love. It lags to bits, but holy crap, I freaking love this little part of town. There's a lot of detail went into this place to build it. And I think I've only got like 3 or 4 episodes out of it so far. And it's not really done yet. It's not really only 3 or 4 episodes. It should be like 1 episode is done. He dropped the container. This guy is crushed. It's so horrible. But at the same time, very, very inspirational. I'm not sure it's that. What? Yeah, dude, that works. That works. Do I dare to cross the road here? I guess I do. Let's make a run for it. So this side is a little bit newer, I guess. We have this part, which is here, which is kind of like the car import lots. And the thing about this is that before or after I built this, somebody created an asset with a big car park with tons of the same vehicles are laying about. But when I searched for it, it didn't exist. So what I have done here, I have placed every single car you see on the screen by hand. And it's a little smart car. Hi, buddy. And that was painful, but it turned out pretty amazing. I know there's like not enough, this is just static. I mean, it doesn't really do much now, does it? It's just here for the looks and no really purpose. But I just think like stuff like this is just, I don't know, it just makes me happy. Small things in life, right? A lot of train props, I don't know. It's just pretty, pretty, pretty cool. This is something amazing as well, like the British industry sector or area over here. Those buildings are super amazing. I can hear a barbecue. Oh, here it is. There we go. Don't worry. We got things on destination. But one day I looked at this place and every single building we've placed was gone. And my heart kind of broke a little bit because there was a bunch of props in between those buildings. And then I had to kind of find props or buildings which kind of fit the theme. So we have done that, and you could get 2 people on here, and it's still burning down to the ground. Are you guys kidding me? Did you guys fix it? thank God for that. I like those buildings a lot, those British like industrial buildings. Beautiful. Then we moved off over here. And I did ask you guys about this. I still haven't kind of like built a building over here, which I feel bad about. I really feel bad about. But we're going to get to that, all right? We're going to get to that and we're going to kind of place a building here and everything's going to be super, 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 super amazing. But that's going to come in a later stage. There's so much decoration and detail going into this place. Look at this. And now it's kind of like depth of field maximum. Why do you not zoom? Or focus, I mean. There we see. There we go. Does it focus now? Yes, it does. Small things in life. Like when you zoom in, this looks horrible. Like look at the gaps in the gate or in the fence. But you know what? I'm still happy about it. It still works out. And look at, by the way, look at the night scenario in this bad boy. It's lit up like a freaking Christmas tree. And it looks pretty awesome. So we're going to kind of move and build the oil harbor over here. We're going to have a passenger terminal here because we do have the passenger terminal. How are you guys going to do this? I see. Well, that's a one way to do it, I guess. Those game mechanics are so derp. I mean, I hate it. I hate it. But what to do, what to do. So yeah, we're going to move on to build like the oil harbor. We're going to have the passenger terminal here. Maybe build something else here because now, I don't know, just having a passenger terminal in this whole region is going to be just bad for us. But we did build the bulk terminal over here. So this is kind of like a dry bulk terminal with tons of stuff. And those ships, don't look at that, all right? It's bad. I know it's bad. But, like, I mean, look at the views from here. Stop. No, it disappeared. It was so amazing with the ship here. But no, he's gone now. I don't know what this guy is still doing here. It's going to be removed, all right? Yeah, there's a little, like, error in the ship route here. So they go in a very wonky shape. Oh, that is so bad. That is so bad. But the view from this area is beautiful. So yeah, so that is something we're gonna change and tweak, I guess, the ship line route. But this is a dry bulk terminal, mainly like for coal, sand, the cement and whatnot, and it works. Everything is pretty awesome. I just noticed like this buffer grill is so repetitive in the city. It's kind of like a McDonald's or Starbucks. It's like, kind of like all over the place, but it's such a nice building. It's gotta be one of my favorite buildings in the game. I know it's bad here, but you have not seen that. Move away, Kiralis. There we go. Perfect. Small detail, small static trains all over the place. And oh my, oh my. Then we went bananas and started building like a Russian suburb. Very, very mixed comments. But I love it. It's not really like a Russian suburb, it's kind of like, it's very mixed, right? Because I was born in Poland and the suburbs like this do exist. With same building all over the place, a lot of concrete. I'm not sure we're missing structures here as well. Something might have disappeared from the Steam Workshop. But this is a fantastic looking place. I just love like those structures. I mean, let me just zoom in and get down. Get down, Ryan. Like, I mean, look at them. Isn't this just super awesome? Doesn't that just make you guys happy? Maybe not, maybe not. Maybe it's just me. But, I don't know, I just love the vibes here. And the thing about the series is kind of like, it's inspirational, right? So I'm going to be picking up stuff. This is going to be, by the way, fixed. Because, I mean, look at like those holes. I mean, they suck. Fill them in. This is what happens when stuff kind of breaks, disappears, and whatnot. But overall, I'm super happy with this region. It's gonna stay. I'm not gonna move it, and it's just for inspiration, right? Inspirational purposes. Kind of wondering how this guy managed to squeeze in on that. Well, dude, he is a professional parker. Is that even a word? Holy crap! He actually squeezed in. into that gap like a freaking boss. Well, I sure am happy for him. And also, where's my mouse at? Okay, so on another screen. There we go. This happens from time to time, and I can't really figure it out. Using the Rico mod, right? The buildings get turned off, and I need to kind of like replop them. Which is, I guess, not a big thing, but it does happen. If anybody gets any suggestions on how to kind of fix that, let me know in the comment section, right? Because it's pretty annoying that I have to kind of repop them all the time. This is from Ukraine. I think it was from Kiev. A little, like, church type of thing. Look at the nice scenario on this bad boy. It's pretty amazing. It's the brightest building in the suburb, that's for sure. And yeah, so then as well, we build a tank factory in the Russian suburb with Russian T-90 tanks. I did remove some of them because they're really, really heavy when it comes to like memory. So they were causing so much lag, so I had to remove some of them, but there are still like bits and pieces remaining here. We have like a beautiful train station, administration buildings, tons of factory buildings, and tons of decoration in between. Okay, this although like this tank model is brilliant. I mean, it looks beautiful. The problem is like a lot of like, ooh, you squeezed in there and perfect. A lot of people doing assets for the game, they just grab a model which is kind of like situated from somewhere else, like some other game and whatnot, and then they kind of like, you know, make it like a little city skyline file and import it. And that causes a problem because they're not really made, like the triangle count on them is super high on some of them. So you should really get like the mesh info and check which assets are kind of like super heavy on your computer and whatnot and disable them or you install them or whatnot. This looks so shabby. Yeah, but we did create this. I think this was a swimming pool, right? If I remember this correctly. It was a little swimming pool over here. And it just looks awesome. We also made this. I'm jumping all over the place. I'm not happy with this anymore. I like it. I do like it. Like, you guys will have to let me know. This is Forsmark. It's a Swedish nuclear power plant. And it was modeled after that. Like, I mean, in real life, even though it kind of disappears a little bit, it looks very similar to like the design with the canal here and that thing over here. But I don't think it's going to stay like this forever. I think we're going to retweak it and make it more harbor-like, but then again, not. We're going to see what we end up having here. And then we're going to match this guy to kind of the design of that guy. Because now it kind of looks like it does fit the theme now. It looks incredible. The colors, everything, I mean, it's beautiful, but it's not gonna fit that well in a cityscape, because this is gonna be a city. This is gonna be connected in the future, I think. Maybe even farms and nuclear, doesn't matter. We're gonna see, right? But if this is gonna be a city, we can't really have so much, like, this looks kind of like it's in the middle of nowhere, and that's what Forsmark is in real life. It's in the middle of nowhere. It's kind of like a big like forest area along the coast in real life. So in that scenario, it works. But in a city scenario, it's not going to work. We also made this American trailer home park. I love this area. It's still not done. It's still under construction, everybody. Here has stuff disappeared. Has stuff disappeared here? Something has disappeared. I think I have Starbucks, and that is also a problem. It's very loud in that district. When you use those concrete fillers or gravel fillers, because this is the area zoned out, right? But it doesn't contain the buildings anymore. So what I have to do is, let me just go into this. Let me just see, do we have, okay, this is a Taco Bell, for example, right? And now we can pop it in using the eyedropper tool, and it's gonna be building up here eventually, I think. There we go. So now it pops in and it's gonna be working again, right? But if this building burns down and there's a concrete or gravel filler, or doesn't matter which filler underneath, even though if it's kind of like zoned, it won't build up, because those fillers are kind of like a building on its own. So that's kind of like the main problem. But I like this area. I know the Walmart has been so criticized in this region, but you don't diss the Walmart, I think. Focus. I think it still fits the theme. It doesn't look that bad. Mouse, there we go. It doesn't look that bad. I know it's oversized and all, but this is going to be expanded in the future. It's going to be big, big farmlands all over the place. Church, beautiful. Train station and Wendy's. There's so much detail all over the place. I know this is not even done. I mean, I kind of took a break from it. But we're going to get back and we're going to do it and we're going to be amazing at it, I guess. Then we have the farmlands. And everything you see here has been on a video. In one time. One time at Bandcamp. No, it's been on a video. So you can just go back, backtrack, and get it watching. For example, like this, like we have trees here and something happened here. So some of the trees disappeared, which kind of sucks a little bit, but I'm just kind of like fearing this. Because this is like, what you're going to call this farm region, which we got going here. It's going to be expanded like in this zone as well. And just this little area here took like literally forever to make. Like for example here, like why just repop? Even though you're the same, there should be like, there should be greenhouses, but hey, it is what it is. I mean, I can take those. Like for example here, pop it here. And this is a concrete filler, so nothing is going to be growing here. But if I do this, stuff will pop up. So some areas I need to really tweak. And I think like mainly the problem over here is that the fire coverage or whatnot is bad. So that it just burns down because the fire tries to reach it. And if we tweak it with that and make it perfect, it's just going to solve all our problems. But it's a little cute area, I think. Oh, see, this is, for example, this is also boom, boom, boom. And grab this guy and boom. But I'm fearing this moment when he's gonna get to that. We also have like log mining, like not mining camps, like lumber mills, or you call it lumber mill, right? Yeah. Like forest areas over here. A little dirt thing over here with like just a bunch of detail going in. Just to make it kind of like simulate a real life scenario, I guess. We have a little mining town, which I haven't really gone back to and tweaked yet. Life here is kind of good. People still live here, but like, I mean, we need a fence alongside here. Popo. So stuff like this is going to be tweaked and fixed. But overall, I mean, a very cozy community. Everything seems still to be working out. It's one of the newest areas in the city. And it just works. This is going to be connected to the farm roads. Need to make more of those guys, by the way. Like, having houses around, stuff like this. I don't know. Detailed decoration. One of my favorite things in the city is this. We have the quarries. This is kind of completed. This is not. We need to add details in that one. Something similar to this, like just bits and pieces like trucks, little factories, little silos and whatnot. But I'm absolutely loving this area. Like just the looks of it, the rails, everything about it is just... just amazing. You guys seem to enjoy this as well, even though it was kind of like a super derp and kind of just a waste of space project, but I like it. Then we have the same quarry design type of thing spread to the other side, but it's not really done yet. But we have some like lakes, which kind of groundwater have sipped in to and stuff. But you can't neglect, it's atmospherical as hell over here. Especially like seeing like everything kind of move about, every single car just kind of roaming about, and I don't know. I'm still surprised that my game actually works, considering all the assets I've got. I think I got closer to like 1,900 assets at this stage. And the crazy thing is, it's kind of assets combined with props. The crazy thing is, I use most of it. The writing center in here in the forest. next to the quarries and the swamp. The swamp community, also one of the latest additions into the city. People are really thriving in here. A lot of houses, a lot of peeps. That looks pretty awesome. It's heading for Killed in Action, Kiraz International Airport, I mean. It's, I think it's on the MD-10. Because I don't see the wings on it, and for some reason that model just disappears. The wings disappear on that model. Well, sometimes you get those assholes. Like, look at this RV. Huh. That's so bad. But it's a fantastic looking model, so I can't remove it. I think it's a model which is kind of like amazing, but it kind of parks out in a very awkward manner. Well, I guess people can just pass on that, but they're not gonna go straight through it because there's no collision detection, I guess, on that. The swamp is beautiful. I like the swamp, even though I kind of want to tweak bits and pieces in it, but I don't think I'm gonna get time to it. So we're going to keep it as it is for now. We're going to expand. Oh, Kirala's house. Hi, Kirala. I'm sitting in that window hereabouts and recording this video. So hi, wave, perfect. Yeah, the swamp is going to be a little bit tweaked, but it's going to be expanded because we do have tons of land this way, which we're going to get to, I guess, in the future. So there's no rushing about. This railway as well going all the way through the swamp. I mean, look at it. Ain't that just amazing? Ay, 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 ay. Also, so we don't forget, Prison Island, which has been a little bit tweaked from the first beginnings, but this is where our prisoners go, and some might say, it's not Top Gear, by the way, but some might say that this is very like Paradise Hotel. Paradise Hotel. It's a paradise, like a hotel destination resort type of situation going on. But it's not. It's a prison island, right? Even though it looks pretty cozy and it looks pretty beautiful. Just imagine sitting here in the cell, just overlooking the boats. And it's kind of like, yeah, they have freedom. They're on a cruise. And I'm sitting here, kind of stuck in my window. I can't move for life or something. It's bad, even though, you know, they are humans too, I guess. Some of them. Lighthouse. I don't know if that has changed colors or whatnot. It looks a little bit different, I guess, from first beginnings. This is still working. We have a little, like, ferry terminal here, which kind of connects it. Even though we do have a tunnel underneath here, which goes underneath here, and then it goes out and across the canal or river, and it goes out here. This is going to be tweaked in the future. This is a temp thing, so we could get some cars in here. Otherwise, this would be kind of like mech. Might even build a bridge to it in the future. I don't know, because I like it. I do like it. We have a few prisons. We have like guard posts, and those are oversized, by the way. Those guard towers. But I'm not gonna judge. Something happened here, by the way. Can you guys see those guys over here in the sky? Ay, 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 ay. You know what happened? I think it's the quay, or key, I mean. The key kind of did it. The key did it. So we need to kind of like just, no, maybe not that one. And let's just bring the land down a little bit. It's something. Don't judge it, alright? No, it's actually fixed now. Perfect. If you see stuff which are like super derp, we're gonna get back to them and fix them in a later state. So don't you worry about that. Well, that's not gonna happen. Then we have this big downtown. I've been recording for like forever now, it kind of feels like, and my voice is kind of going fiddly-faddly. But this is something which is gonna be so expanded in the future. It's really hard because for me to focus on one project at the same time. As you might have noticed, like, I'm kind of like all over the place doing new projects and starting new things, and but most of the stuff is going to be fixed, and we're going to get back to the stuff as well. What was that sign, by the way? There's something. Okay, that's the Russian suburb, which are kind of like complaining about the Rico houses, I guess. This is a beautiful place. I'm loving it. We have like the road going underneath from the Brooklyn suburb. Oh, we also have this, by the way. I'm going to get to that. I don't know. We have this little canal thingy, which goes underneath the whole river, goes up here. goes underneath the stadium as well, which is the kind of like the little tennis stadium over here. And then it goes into the kind of like main city. It goes across here. And you can get out here as well. This is something which is really bad. And that's mainly because we only have like one exit into the main, or one entrance into the main city for now. So yeah, that's bad. Like from the highway at least. So I think we need to tweak. It's not super bad, but it causes situations like this, which is kind of like, why you do that? I don't know, but they do. But night scenarios in this place, incredible. We have the World Trade Center, like a tribute thingy. We have the, like, I think this was the commercial district, right? Mostly like commercial buildings and banks and whatnot. Same goes for this. We even have the Empire State Building, and this is a building to love. Look at how it's lit up here on the top of it. It's pretty beautiful. We also have those New Yorkish buildings, which are pretty new. Night scenarios, they look really awesome. I'm not gonna judge the night scenarios. Day scenarios, they look a little bit crap. But I was watching like a show from New York today, and like a reality thingy, and they're pretty similar to New York buildings. Like, they do have them, maybe not as often and spread out, but they're very similar. So for the moment being, just gonna keep them. We're gonna get back and tweak and kind of fill in all the gaps which are kind of like not really built up yet. Central Park is situated here, not finished yet, but it's gonna be. We're gonna get to that. Like, I mean, there's bits and pieces which we need to get back and stuff too. For example, this, I did ask you guys about this little like logistics center which we did. I don't like it anymore. It's not a bad looking building, but it just not fits the theme here in the center of or in the heart of the kind of city anymore. So we might move that away a little bit, but overall it's not bad looking. It's pretty decent. Not really sure what this was. I think this was like an office district which we started, and this is like the vanilla buildings only, like the vanilla buildings to like 99%. And the vanilla buildings are really not as nice looking. So I think we might kind of tweak and go custom buildings in this in a later stage, and kind of just tweak them out and kind of remove them. But we're gonna see. Then we have Brooklyn. This is same over and over again. But I love, like, let me just show you. I think it's from this angle, for example, like. If we just go into kind of like another scenario when it comes to, let me just see here, maybe like, let's go like evening. I love how you can just see all those antennas and roof decorations all over the place. And they're so, it's so detailed. It's absolutely beautiful. And then you just kind of jump down on street level here, and I don't know, it's just got a cool vibe to it. It's huge. I know it's a lot of same but different, but I mean, just take a peek and embrace. I'm kind of liking it. We have a beautiful stadium, of course, which is the, what did you call again? Where can I grab you? Where is your pinpoint? Let me just see. Is it here? It's the Melbourne Cricket Ground Olympic Stadium. I'm not sure it's called that in real life, but it's here. It looks pretty fab, and we're gonna keep it for now. This is gonna be purified, so don't you guys go rage about it. We also have the airport, which is kind of like one of the latest additions in the city. Fully working so far, still not done. Like, look at this approach. Are you kidding me? Which is you? You are Hawaiian Airlines, and this is a Qantas plane. Okay, this is gonna be bad. Okay, this is gonna be really bad. This is really bad now. They're kind of sniffing each other. I don't know. Why don't they have collision detection? Like, in that case, like, how come this guy. Oh, that looks amazing. How come those two guys land at the exact same time? Should be something just telling, like, okay, you don't do that now because you do blah, blah, blah. I don't know. Anyways, we have a little commercial district over here across the road with four dealership, Toyota dealerships. We have Target, Home Depots, and whatnot. Also going to be expanded. We have the parking zones, which is kind of like one of the latest additions. We have like the bus depot, central train station, and a lot of parking garages. As you can see, there's gaps here because we need to fill it with stuff in the future. But yeah, it's kind of amazing. It's getting there. Like, it's bits and pieces all over the place. And stuff is going to be improved. This is the one thing which we did in the last episode. The little, like, mountain community. Very thriving still. I'm loving those houses. I think those houses models are amazing. Oh, Popo? Oh, he just stopped there just to check it right. Ooh. Okay, okay. You're good. Perfect, yes. I'm loving this part. I think it's just cozy, and we're gonna kind of build this up and build like a mountain treetop thing up here. People suggesting like observatory, like observatory, like star things, or even a castle would kind of work. I guess some mentioned that. So we're gonna see where this takes us. But I'm recording this for like 50 minutes something. I've been talking a lot, and I'm really getting to the point where I can't really talk anymore. And this video has been long enough. This is, by the way, really cool. Oh yeah, we forgot about this. This is a little American suburb next to the swamp. It's pretty amazing. There's a lot of American, like, American suburb houses. It's huge. It's very laggy. But yeah, this, such a derp idea we had. Like, this is one of the first episodes we did, like, with the sunken things. And it turned out pretty good, even though it's not really used that much besides having, like, a city connection here. But it's gonna be. It's going to be train tracks extended from this and going somewhere else. Like, I think into the industrial zone, which might expand. Yeah, I don't know. Here, maybe somewhere. We're going to see. We're going to see. But that's it for me, I guess, everybody. Like, I mean, I wish I could go into ground level, but it's so lag at this stage. And I've been recording for such a long time, so you guys will absolutely hate it, I guess. So, well, maybe not. But it's been a long video anyhow. So we do have the full city tour. Everything is seen. Everything is pretty amazing. So this game delivers, I tell you. And it's so cheap as well. I'm not getting paid for to say this or anything. But if you're into city building games, this is the best one, and do grab it. You get so much value for the money. And the Steam Workshop is just amazing. It is just amazing. So many items. I think it's like 85,000 items on the Steam Workshop with mods included or assets. Just nuts. And the new are added every single day. So anyhow, everybody, I'm sorry. I know we should kind of like go in on details, street level details and stuff, but we might do that in future. I think in each episode I'm going to do some type of street activity. This is mainly a city tour for those who missed and stuff. Stuff is going to be retweaked, as mentioned. This is going to be retweaked and remodeled. I think we're going to kind of delete it all and kind of redo it. Same goes for this area. I think might not really delete the road networks, but might delete the buildings and kind of rebuild the whole shablang. Ay, 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 ay. 50 episodes, and we have not really done much yet. It's a lot of room to fill, and hopefully my computer will handle it all. So I guess from this view at morning, and let me just go to about like, there we go. Pretty amazing. I just want to say thank you so much for watching, everybody. See you guys in the next one. Hit the like button if you did enjoy. You don't have to. It's a plane coming in. It's a Thai Airlines plane with a fish or bird, I mean. Not really sure what that is. Can you guys see how it kind of glitches? Is that the billboards who'd caused it? Because I do have... It doesn't really matter. I don't have to do it in the current. But there's a little black like pixel thingy going on here. And I do see it here as well. And there's billboards as well. So it's the billboards which are causing it. Huh. Alright, now we know. Whoop. There we go. Thank you so much for watching. See you guys in the next episode. Kiralis, over and out. Bye-bye.